Welcome back. Let's review pointers. First, it is important to review what is a variable. A variable is a space in the memory that stores a value, right? So when you do something like this, int x equals 5, what you are doing is to give a name to a space in the memory. That name is x. But that space has an address. Every single space in the memory has an address. So we can imagine that this hexadecimal number is the address of this box. So a variable has an address and also has a name. And inside of the variable, you can store a value. So you have the address, the name, and inside the value. You already know that. A pointer is a variable, but it's a particular type of variable. It's a variable that is used to store an address instead of a value. To create a pointer, you put this asterisk here between the type and the name of the variable. So int x is an integer variable. Int asterisk y make y to be a pointer to an integer value. Then you can store in y not a value, but an address. Do you remember that we use the ampersand to get the address of a variable? We use that in the scanf function. So in this example, ampersand x will be 0xd4 because that is the address of the variable x. And what we're doing here is to store that address 0xd4 in the variable y. And because y is a pointer, a variable that stores address, that number 0xd4 can be stored inside of y. Now, you can notice this. Y is a variable. Therefore, it has an address 0xd8. It's a particular address of this green box in the memory of your computer. Inside of the variable, you store a value. And that particular value happened to be an address. Y is called a pointer, and in particular, in this scenario, y is pointing to x. Let's review a full example. Here we have a variable x that is an integer. We have y, again, as a pointer. And here we store the address of x in y. So what happened in the memory is something like this picture. You have the variable with the value, and you have the pointer with the address of the variable. To make it short, 0xd4 is the address of x, and is also stored inside of y. So y is pointing to x. The importance of this is the following. You can print the value of the variable x with the name of the variable, like here, but also you can access the variable x and the value that is inside using the pointer. In order to do so, you use the asterisk again, like this line. If you notice, this line and this one both are printing 5. In the first case, because you access directly x as usual, but here, because you are having access to the value in the address 0xd4. The asterisk here represents this arrow. So asterisk y is something like go to the address stored in y 0xd4 and get the value there. As you can see, there are two important operators to remember when we are working with pointers. The first one is the ampersand. The ampersand gets the address of a variable, and the other is the asterisk. And the asterisk have two uses. The first one is to create the pointer, like here. When you use the asterisk in the middle of the type and the name, you are creating a pointer. But also, the asterisk helps you to use the name of the pointer and be able to access the value in the address that is pointed by the pointer. Another thing to notice here is that you can print the address of a variable using the control symbol %p, p as a pointer. So in these three lines here, what we want to print are addresses, the address of x, the address of y, and y itself, and y is a pointer, therefore have an address. And as you can notice, when you print those three lines, what you have on the screen are hexadecimal numbers. Usually, you are going to use hexadecimal numbers to represent address in the memory. If you copy and paste this program and you run this program in your computers, something that you are going to notice is every single time that you execute your program, those values could be different. It's just because the space in the memory that those variables are going to use can change every single time. So we have pointers that store the address of variables, but we can have pointers that store the address of another pointer, something like this picture. In order to do this, we need to create a pointer to a pointer, and that means using two asterisks for that. So this one, C, is a pointer to a pointer. Asterisk, asterisk, C is a variable that is gonna store the address of a pointer, in this case, Y. So you can store the address of Y in C. And then in Y, you can store the address of X, and X is a variable. Then you can print the value 5 using the name of the variable that have that value, in this case, X. You can access the value of X using the pointer Y. So you can print asterisk Y, and that is gonna be 5. But also you can access the value in X using asterisk, asterisk C. Again, you can think about the asterisk here like one asterisk for each arrow in the picture. So it's like read the address in C, 0x90, and go to that address. Read the value in that address, 0xac, and go to that address. And that is what you are gonna print, in this case, 5. This is similar to what happened with arrays. Remember, you can have unidimensional arrays, bidimensional arrays, three-dimensional arrays, and so on, adding pairs of square brackets. Here, you can have pointers, pointers to pointers, pointers to pointers to pointers to pointers, and so on, adding asterisk in the declaration between the type and the name of the pointer. Running this program, the result is like this. I will recommend you to play with this source code. Copy the source code in your computers, play with this, and be sure that you understand what is happening here. Let's use this example to review two more things. Number one, when you put a value 0 in a pointer, like here, those pointers are not going to point to the address 0, but that value represents a null pointer. This line, put the value 12 in A, B and C are pointers, and both are empty. Next, if you notice here, for B and C, what we can store is the address. In B, you can store the address of A, so the address of a variable in a pointer. In C, you can store the address of B, so the address of a pointer in a pointer to pointer. And here, you can use B or C to change the value in the variable A. So asterisk B equal 24 will store the 24 in the variable A. But later, asterisk asterisk C equal to 48 is going to store 48 in the variable A because the pointing. So when you print here the value of A, B, and C, as you can see, A is going to be equal to 48. B is pointing to A and C is pointing to B. One last thing to review is the relationship between pointers and arrays. Arrays are pointers. The name of an array is basically a variable that stores the address of the first of a sequence of elements. So, for instance, when you create an array A, you are gonna have in the memory a pointer with the name A that stores the address of the first element of the array, like here, A is an array, and the first element is in 0x48, and that address is stored in A. The importance of this is that this notation, A square bracket and the index of the element, 0, 1, 2, 3, is equivalent to use the operator asterisk and basically add to the value of A, that is a pointer, the index. So what you are doing is to add 0, 1, 2, 3 to the address that you have in the pointer. And the result of that operation is that you get the address of the particular element in the array. In fact, this is the reason because the element of an array starts with the number 0. Because when you do 0 plus the address, you get the first element. And you have the address of the first element initially in the pointer. In this example, you can see how this works. For instance, in this line, we can access one element in the array A using the index with the square brackets. But also we can use the operator asterisk and do an addition between the array and the index. In fact, this line in blue can be write in all these different ways, and all of those are the same. Moreover, we can have a pointer pointing to an array. Here, we create a new pointer, Q, and when you assign Q equal A, that is gonna put the address of the first element of the array A in Q, and the result is gonna be like in this picture. As you can notice, there are only one array. The green boxes that represent the elements exist only one time. However, we have two pointers, A and Q, pointing to the first element. Therefore, you can access the array using A or Q, and you can use the asterisk or the square bracket. I recommend you to play with this code. Try to print the values in the array, print the address of the different values, print the values in the array using A or Q, play with the notation that use the square brackets and the notation that use the asterisk, use the percentage P to print the address of A and the address of Q, the value stored in A and the value stored in Q, and so on. See you next video.